now generation. This is Ms. J. This is day 18 of our 29-day challenge. We are halfway through the challenge, guys. Actually, more than halfway through. But this week, we're going to be talking about intimacy and just our relationship with God. So hopefully, we started to keep on opening up. Father God, we just thank you for this day. Thank you for all that you're doing, Father. I pray that you would just speak with us, devotion, Father. I pray that this week, just draw closer to you, Father. And just reveal your heart for us, Lord God. Your desire just to be close to us, Father, as a loving Father. Thank you so much. Thank you for this, what you do. In Jesus' name, amen. Alright, so when you look at the word intimacy, intimacy means close familiarity or friendship, or in just plain terms, closeness. The scripture that we're going to look at for today is Genesis 1:26-27, and it says, "Then God said, let us make human beings in our image to be like us. We will reign over the fish in the sea and the birds in the sky, the livestock and all the wild animals on the earth, the small animals that scurry along the ground. So God created human beings in his own image. The image of God he created male." I think the important thing that we see in the scripture text is that it said, "Let us," which means that God, the Father, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit decided to make man in something. Look at ourselves, we are an image of who God is. We are a copy of what God looks like. And when we think about intimacy, I think about closeness. Like, when we think about intimacy, I think about my relationship with my mom, Prophetess. Prophetess birthed me from her womb, and immediately from that, when I came out of her womb, there was an instant connection with Prophetess. She was my mom. There was an instant connection with the apostle. And it's the same thing with God. Like, as soon as we even thought about, like, as soon as God decided that we were coming to the earth, he built a connection with us. And it's crazy that he took so much time to create man. Like, it's just, everything else seems like he's just spoken into existence. But it says that he formed man to his own image. And that he took time with us. And even when we've been talking about Pastor Reed's pride, dealing with temptation, I think that the aspect of love, talk about intimacy, plays a very key role, because we now understand that because God loved us so much, he created us in his own image. Because God loved us so much, he sent Jesus down on the cross for our sins. And so one thing I want you guys to think about this week as we go through these devotionals is think about a relationship that you have with somebody. For me, my biggest relationship that I have right now is hanging out with my wife. And think about how much you love that person, how much you care for that person. Think about how much that person means to you. And then I want you to write down a few things. This is going to be you guys' challenge for today. I want you guys to write down at least 4 or 5 things of characteristics of why you love that person. Why is that person important to you? Tomorrow, we're going to talk about some of the things you guys write down. I want you guys also to begin to ask God where your relationship is. A lot of you know where your relationship is, but if you don't know where you stand with God, ask him. He's there to talk to to talk to. He's there to encourage you. He's there to lift you up. Don't be afraid to talk to him, because even as you have a connection with your mom and your dad, you have that same connection with God. So he's never far away from you. He's always right there to hold you, to guide you, to lift you up, to bring you to where he wants you to be. So, like I said, for y'all's assignment for tonight, I want you guys to write down, I'm going to say, four things about someone you dearly love. Write down the characteristics of why you love them. And I want you to send it to me. You can either send it to me via GroupMe. You can send it to me via text message. And I'll post my number in the GroupMe message. And then I'll do the message group chat. And then we'll discuss those things tomorrow for our devotional for tomorrow. Love you guys. Pray y'all have a great night. Good luck on finals this week. And I will see you guys tomorrow.